All right, so what we've done now is we've actually downloaded all of our database from import.io. And if you scroll down, you can see that actually there are 4,763 rows. So we actually have information about 4,762 clinics and a header row. Now, overall, this looks pretty good. We have the source URL, the clinic name, what services are offered there, what the address is, latitude, longitude, and contact information where that is available. But there's something else that I want to do here, and there are a couple of things that we need to do to tidy up this data just a little bit. One of the things that I would like to do is to actually have information about what province within South Africa each of these clinics are located in. Now, there are a few different ways that we can do this, but if you'll note that in the source URL, it actually contains right here Gauteng, Western Cape. So that actually has some of the province information there. It's actually also included in the address for the most part, but I know for sure that it's in the URL. So I'm going to create a function that actually extracts it from that URL. So after the address column, what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a new column. There we are. All right, I'm going to give that a title and we're going to call that province. Now, how in the world do we see if this cell here, B2, contains, let's say Western Cape, contains the information for Western Cape? Well, the easiest thing to do is we're just going to do a function called search. And what are we going to search? We want to search Western Cape in quotation marks to show that it's text. And then we're going to tell it which cell to search. And there we are. What it's done is it says, no, basically that doesn't exist because that doesn't have it, because those are all in Gauteng. But if we scroll down one to something that is in the Western Cape, we see that we actually get a number. Otherwise, we're not getting a number, which means that it doesn't exist in there. So we're going to build on this function a little bit, and we're going to put that entire function in two brackets. And what we want to know is actually, is this a number? So the function is quite simply, is this a number? And now that says false because that's in Gauteng, which is a different province. But if we scroll down to here, it says true. And now we need to see if this is true, i.e., is this a number? Does this contain that particular value? What do we want it to do? We want to replace it with the title of the province, Western Cape. So we just need to turn this into an if function. And we see the first thing is the logical test, which we already have. If it is a number, then we want it to display Western Cape. And we've put that in quotation marks to show that it's text. And for now, if not, what we're going to do is we're going to just have it display zero. All right, but there we are. If we've done that, it now displays that that is in the province Western Cape, and we can drag that up there, and we see because that is still in the Gauteng province that that is zero. Right, so we have this built out just if you look at this record, we have this built out just for one to check the Western Cape. But there are nine provinces in South Africa. So what I'm going to do is I've actually created here one a very long built out version of this function. All right, but it's doing the exact same thing. So it's saying if this cell contains Eastern Cape, display Eastern Cape. Otherwise, check to see if it's Free State. If it's Free State, call it Free State. Otherwise, check if it says Gauteng, etc., 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 through all of the nine provinces. So it looks like a bit of a crazy function, but it absolutely works. And I'll go ahead and delete these for the time being. If you and double click, it will fill down the entire 4,762 rows. So now we have it's showing those are in Haotang, that's in Western Cape, that's in Free State, etc., etc. So we now have the different provinces, which is exactly what we were looking for. What I am going to do, just to kind of, or the provinces are here rather. What I do want to do is I will copy all of that, and I will basically just paste this as a new row, and I will paste special, or as a new column rather. I will paste special, and I will only paste the values rather than the actual formula itself, so that we have that actually just locked in right there like that. All right, so that's one thing that I wanted to do to clean up that data. That we might want to do is to tidy up this little element here about the services. So there's HIV treatment, counseling, testing, male circumcision, medical male circumcision, that is, etc., etc. And so I'm going to use a process almost exactly the same as what we've just done before, and I'm going to break out each of those services into its own column. Right, so why don't we go ahead and build out that formula just like we did in the last time? And so we can start by saying search, and we want the text HIV treatment, and then we want to give it a comma, and then we want to actually search the cell D2, simple as. And it says at position one, at very character one within there, we have found that. So that's great, but that's not exactly what we want yet. We want to know if that is a number. And that is true. So we know that it has HIV treatment facilities there. We could leave this as just a true or false, but for some of the counts that I'm going to be doing later, I just think it's easier to have ones or zeros. So I'm going to put if is number one. That is, if it's true, zero, if it's false, there we are. Pretty much, and then I'm going to have it fill out that entire row, but there we are. And I'm going to repeat that for medical male circumcision, etc. So what I've done is I've duplicated this formula right here, and instead I've substituted in HIV counseling, which is one of the services, HIV testing, medical male circumcision, and circumcision. And all I need to do is select those four columns, double click there, and it will actually go ahead and fill out all of my rows. So we see HIV counseling is quite popular, testing not so much. What I will do is the exact same thing in terms of I will take this and I will make sure that it has not just these formula in there, these functions, but I will copy and paste all of these again, all of these columns. I'll do the same thing again where we paste special and we'll only paste the values, and there we are. Now we have all the information that we need. We can actually delete these columns that have the actual formula in them. But I'm going to keep them in there for you just so that you actually have that